I started martial arts by accident, and my dad laid carpet for a living, so he was going to lay carpet in one of his jobs, and I went with him that day. It was in a martial arts school, and while he was laying the carpet, the instructor, which is my instructor, Master Anderson, took me off to the side and just did some moves with me and did a little introductory lesson, and I was sold from there.
My parents had initially started me because I was having some trouble with bullying at school, and I was pretty shy, and it was one of those things that I had wanted to do for years, pretending I was a Ninja Turtle. And
my parents had started before me, and they would not, they didn't take children back then. And so once I turned 5, I convinced my parents. I kept begging so much that they, you know, really knew how much I really wanted to do Taekwondo. And so they went into the instructor and convinced them to let me take class. And I was the youngest. I was the only 5-year-old. And the next oldest child in the class was 12.
I had a student who came to me once. His name was Tony, and he had had a stroke. And his whole right side of his body was paralyzed. His right leg, his right arm, he couldn't speak. He'd lost that ability. But he wanted to do martial arts. About 3 years later, he tested for his black belt. And at that point, he was able to stand on his bad leg and break a board waist level, and his bad arm could come up all the way up over his head. And when he tested for his black belt, it was probably, as an instructor, one of the most proud moments I had.
You couldn't get me in front of people. 20 years ago, I wasn't gonna teach a class. I wasn't gonna talk to anybody. I was the person that wanted to be in the back, and you lead, I follow. And the instructors, Chief Master Leggy, all the Masters Council, the Founders Council, they all make you want to become a better person, and they make you want to be the best that you can be. And they don't settle for much less than that.
Mastership in general means, to me, a sense of accomplishment, going down a long road, and it's like, wow, it's here. It also means, too, a new beginning.
Being dedicated to the martial art of ATA, and to just training with a great heart, having great people to influence me, to push me to be where I'm at.
I believe that when you put your mind and your heart into it, I believe that you can achieve it. I can teach somebody or pass on to somebody that would be a deal in my job.
I think all those as a culmination make me move up to the next step and then allow me to share those experiences and wisdom with my students, other instructors, and hopefully make them better than I ever was.
Song-Am masters stretch from Canada to Argentina and across to Asia, representing 6 continents around the world, proving that we are indeed ATA strong worldwide. Soon to join the ranks of these esteemed individuals are the 2013 Masterclass. Ladies and gentlemen, the traditional Master Ceremony.
Philosophically, there are 9 symbols of ceremony to induct an instructor into mastership. Vision. Respect. Loyalty, knowledge, gratitude, humility, honor, nobility, and finally, mastership. Now, get ready to experience the culmination of this honored tradition. Tonight, you will meet the instructors who have dedicated their lives to teaching Taekwondo and life skills forever as they have chosen the path to mastership. These 6th degree black belt instructors are
Master Nominee from San Jose, Uruguay, Alexis Cabrera.
Master Nominee from Eagan, Minnesota, Matt Blomquist.
Master Nominee from Conifer, Colorado, Laura Lee Roberts.
Master Nominee from Fort Collins, Colorado, Kevin Rogers.
Master Nominee from Apex, North Carolina, Alex Changho.
Master Nominee from Warner Robins, Georgia, Eric Cobbs.
Master Nominee from Las Vegas, Nevada, April Martin Derrick.
Master nominee from Chanhassen, Minnesota, Jonathan Gleisner.
Master nominee from Janesville, Wisconsin, Michael Plussel.
Master nominee from Elk Grove, California, Jiang Kang.
Master nominee from Brazil, Luis Boton.
Master nominee from Apopka, Florida, Luis Zamboni.
Master nominee from Southlake, Texas, Wesley Boyer.
Master nominee from San Angelo, Texas, Randy Carvin.
Master nominee from Asunción, Paraguay, Jorge Leguizamón.
Master nominee from Owensboro, Kentucky, Michael Jones.
Master nominee from Canton, Georgia, Scott Murphy.
Master nominee from Haslett, Michigan, Ron Frank Birch Jr.
Master nominee from Anaheim, California, Huangmiang Huang.
Master nominee from Burnsville, Minnesota, John Probst.
Master nominee from Lexington, Kentucky, Julie Moberly.
Master nominee from Los Angeles, California, Taekwon Lee.
Master nominee from Woodbury, Minnesota, Dave Niska.
Master nominee from Devil's Lake, North Dakota, Ryan Arndt.
Master nominee from Little Rock, Arkansas, Thomas Jacobs.
Master nominee from Eugene, Oregon, Russ Dewar.
Master nominee from Littleton, Colorado, Steve Lucero.
Master nominee from Cary, North Carolina, Julia Wegman.
Master nominee from Grand Forks, North Dakota, Casey Mahalik.
Master nominee from Chandler, Arizona, Donald Garcia.
Master nominee from Houston, Texas, Charles Sears.
Master nominee from Tulsa, Oklahoma, Betty Scott.
Master nominee from Tallahassee, Florida, George Heller.
During the quest for senior mastership, I took on a lot of new beginnings in my life. And therefore, the difference was is that I learned that instead of it being an end, it was a beginning. And when you treat things like a beginning, you have a lot more zest and passion for it.
Senior master's just like everything else. It's one step at a time. And it's a higher title, but I still feel the same. I still feel like I have to work as hard as I did before. It's not that anything's easier. It's definitely more challenging.
Proudly wearing the senior master's uniform made of royal blue silk, these seventh degree black belt instructors are.
Senior master nominee from Henderson, Nevada, Leland Brandon.
Senior master nominee from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Arlen R. Benson.
Senior master nominee from Chicago, Illinois, Kelly Shoup.
Senior master nominee from Gainesville, Florida, Ricardo Fabian Valigno.
Senior master nominee from Parlin, New Jersey, Jack McInerney.
Senior master nominee from Tucson, Arizona, C. Andrew Lather II.
Senior master nominee from Ames, Iowa, Bill Phillips.
Senior master nominee from Cave Creek, Arizona, Greg Moody.
Senior master nominee from Las Vegas, Nevada, David Inman.
Senior master nominee from Little Rock, Arkansas, Larry Spencer.
Senior master nominee from South Brunswick, New Jersey, Carla Capobianco.
Senior master nominee from Raleigh, North Carolina, Michael Wegman.
Senior master nominee from Nevada, Iowa, Larry Edel.
Senior master nominee from Denham Springs, Louisiana, Dwayne Dendy.
Chief master, again, responsibility. And just, it's what people expect to see out of you, so it's what you expect to see out of yourself.
Even though we have accomplished some physical and some mental and emotional challenges together, I still feel like it is just preparing me for the next step of my life. And so I'm truly humbled that I can even be at this level to push even a little bit further in my life.
A chief master instructor must take the role of a leader amongst leaders. Proudly wearing the chief master's uniform made of crimson red silk.
Chief master nominee from Linwood, Washington, Cho Ki Sung.
Chief master nominee from Orlando, Florida, Master Von Schmelin.
Chief master nominee from Round Rock, Texas, Michael Niblock.
Chief master nominee from Evansville, Indiana, Cheryl Bryce.
Chief master nominee from Miami, Florida, Tony Isaacs.
Chief master nominee from Tampa, Florida, Laura Cocobani.
The master ceremony is traditionally divided into 9 parts, the first of which is the sounding of the gong. The gong, according to tradition, sounds 9 times slowly, once for each level of colored belt rank. As a complete circle, the gong represents the beginning and the end. This week, the master inductees were in Little Rock to prepare for their inductions. They gathered at the H.U. Lee International Gate and Garden to perform the following steps.
Respect. The remembrance of ancestors is a deeply honored tradition. To show respect, these inductees will perform 3 traditional Korean bows. Traditionally, the inductees bow 3 times, representing their mind, body, and spirit.
The torch of knowledge can be passed on by the fire of a candle. The candle must burn continually to keep the torch of knowledge alive. It will constantly sacrifice itself as the body of wax melts away in order to keep the flame burning. It will do so until the body no longer remains.
The inductees will now light their candles from the flame of Grand Master Lee. By doing so, they are confirming their commitment to stay loyal to the students of Sangam Taekwondo. Just as the candle, they will constantly sacrifice their body to teach the knowledge they have gained from Grand Master Lee to their students. With this commitment, they will perpetuate the flame of knowledge for generations to come.
The inductees will symbolically demonstrate the ceremonial passing of knowledge at the flowing veins of water from the fountain under the guidance of Grand Master Lee.
This 9-foot-tall fountain is a symbol of the passing of knowledge. The eternal Grand Master H.U. Lee believed he could make the world a better place, one black belt at a time, by sharing his knowledge.
Water is symbolic of knowledge. In front of the master inductees are 3 bowls, the smallest representing the knowledge of a student. The middle-sized bowl is the knowledge of an instructor, and the final, large bowl is that of a master.
The small bowl, representing the knowledge gained by a student, is full, demonstrating that the inductees have already learned all there is to know about being a student of Sangam Taekwondo. They will empty the water of this bowl into the master's bowl.
The middle-sized bowl is also full, representing their completeness of knowledge as an instructor. Again, they will complete the process of pouring the water into the master's bowl.
The large bowl, that of a master, was empty, but now has been partially filled with all of their knowledge as a student and an instructor. However, this bowl is not yet full.
The chosen cannot fill the bowl alone. The inductees will now take the bowl and let the Grand Master's water fill it, thus representing that he will guide and teach them the way of a true master. After the ceremonial passing of knowledge, it is only fitting that the master inductees show their gratitude to the Grand Master. They offer a gift to represent appreciation for the knowledge, leadership, and guidance that the Grand Master has sacrificed for them in their quest to mastership.
By tradition, the gift is a gold coin. The gold symbolizes devotion and loyalty in their hearts. Each new master has a special personal meaning behind the gift. This gift is a symbol to show the worth of the student-instructor relationship.
Honor is defined as the adherence to what is right and just. These instructors have devoted their lives adhering to what is right. They have also chosen the honorable path to teach what they have learned, thus earning their place of the exalted position amongst the masters. In recognition of this honorable act, the inductees are presented a gold ring. This ring is made of gold and black onyx, inset with a diamond. The diamond represents Grand Master's loyalty forever to the masters.
The inductees will also be presented with a certificate of mastership on which the Grand Master has affixed his seal from the turtle of the Birongbong.
Humility. Witness as the inductees honor the oath of the Master to the Sabun Nim, Grand Master Li. Master inductees, please stand and raise your supported right hand.
Do you swear that by accepting this position as Master Instructor, you will dedicate the remaining years of your life to guide the students, black belts, and instructors on a journey to mastership in both their physical and mental development, and that in your personal life, you will live daily as an example of the Songhum spirit of Taekwondo, following in the path that Grand Master Li has forged for you, and sacrificing yourself daily for the betterment of Taekwondo, to this do you swear?
As it was with the warriors of ancient times, titles and positions were bestowed upon a recipient by dubbing him with a sword or scepter. The Grand Master will dub the inductees with the Birongbong, the Staff of the Flying Dragon, thus demonstrating their crossover from instructor to master instructor.
The Birongbong, which is only to be touched by the Grand Master's hands, will symbolize the completion of their walk as a student and instructor, and reveal their new path as that of a master. Now you will witness live as our inductees make the crossover to mastership in Songhum Taekwondo.
Alexis Cabrera, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Alexis Cabrera.
Matt Blomquist, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Matt Blomquist.
Laura Lee Roberts, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Laura Lee Roberts.
Kevin Rogers, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Kevin Rogers. Alex Chang Ho, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Alex Chang Ho. Eric Cobbs, the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Eric Cobbs.
April Martin Derrick, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master April Martin Derrick.
Jonathan Gleisner, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Jonathan Gleisner.
Michael Plessel, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Michael Plessel.
Ji Young Kong, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Ji Young Kong.
Luis Fatone, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Luis Fatone.
Louise Zamboni, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Louise Zamboni.
Wesley Boyer, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Wesley Boyer.
Randy Carvin, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Randy Carvin.
Jorge Lu Guizamon, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Jorge Lu Guizamon.
Michael Jones, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Michael Jones.
Scott Murphy, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Scott Murphy.
Ronald Birch Jr., the Grand Master now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Ronald Birch Jr.
Kwang Myung Huang, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Kwang Myung Huang.
John Probst, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master John Probst.
Julie Moberly, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Julie Moberly.
Taekwon Lee, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Taekwon Lee.
Dave Niska, the Grandmaster now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Dave Niska.
Ryan Arndt, the Grand Master, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Ryan Arndt.
Thomas Jacobs, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Thomas Jacobs.
Russ Dewar, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Russ Dewar.
Steve Lucero, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Steve Lucero.
Julia Wegman, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Julia Wegman.
Casey Mihalik, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Casey Mihalik.
Donald Garcia, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Donald Garcia.
Charles Sears, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Charles Sears.
Betty Scott, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master Betty Scott.
George Heller, the Grandmaster, now dubs you Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Master George Heller.
The seventh degree instructors have passed their requirements and will be dubbed Senior Master Instructors. Leland Brandon, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Leland Brandon.
Arlen Benson, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Arlen Benson.
Kelly Shoup, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Kelly Shoup. Ricardo Valigno, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Ricardo Valigno. Jack McInerney, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Jack McInerney.
C. Andrew Latherow II, the Grand Master, now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master C. Andrew Latherow II.
Bill Phillips, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Bill Phillips.
Greg Moody, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Greg Moody.
David Inman, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master David Inman.
Larry Spencer, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Larry Spencer.
Carla Capobianco, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Carla Capobianco.
Michael Wegman, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Michael Wegman.
Larry Edel, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Larry Edel.
Dwayne Dendy, the Grand Master now dubs you Senior Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Senior Master Dwayne Dendy.
The 8th degree instructors have passed their requirements and will be dubbed Chief Master Instructors.
Ki Sung Cho, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Ki Sung Cho.
Master Von Schmeling, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Von Schmeling.
Michael Niblock, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Michael Niblock.
Cheryl Bryce, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Cheryl Bryce.
Tony Isaacs, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Tony Isaacs.
Laura Cocobani, the Grand Master now dubs you Chief Master Instructor. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Chief Master Laura Cocobani. Ladies and gentlemen, Grand Master In-Ho Lee and the Sangam style of Taekwondo introduce to you the Masterclass of 2013.